Sean Kincade Show on 97.5, The Fanatic, Philadelphia.
In the Lynch Pin, Jamie found something that he thought was the most encouraging part of the victory on Sunday.
This is the Lynch Pin.
Jordan Mailata, Jalen Reagor, Quez Watkins, Devontae Smith, Josh Sweat, Miles Sanders, Kenneth Gainwell, Jalen Hurts. You'd say they all performed pretty damn well on Sunday, right?
I'd say fantastically, many of them.
They're all under the age of 25.
That's fantastic.
To me, not only is the youth contributing, but they're going to be focal points of this team. And they all answered the bell week one. Now, look, I'm not crowning them all as, you know, made NFL players yet, but you got to start somewhere. And to see Devontae Smith, I think he's safe to say he's legit as hell. I don't think we have to worry about him. But to see a Gainwell get 11 touches in his first game, to see Jordan Mailata plowing people over, to see Josh Sweat all over the field as a defensive end, there's a lot to like about the youth all of a sudden with this Eagles team. And it's pretty damn cool, because 6 months ago we were going, where's the youth?
Yes, we were.
And I think they have some answers, because the core is the core. You know, the Lane Johnsons, Brandon Brooks, Kelsey's, Cox's, Graham's. But they're not going to be here forever. So you have to, you know, manage their expectations while trying to win at the same time, but also building towards the future in this weird year. And I think you're seeing a lot of positives early on here.
I think that's fair. Young.
Yeah.
Gets excited.
Look, they're getting a chance, and there's going to be ups and downs. It's not going to be Atlanta Falcons all the time.
No, of course not.
But they're getting that chance. And you're right, Jamie. That's what you want out of a team that's, air quotes, rebuilding here. So, first test, great. It was good to see. I can't wait to see more of it.
Sure.
I really can. And I want to see... And I'll be on the lookout today. I want to see the backup camera on Devontae Smith and how he got open on his plays.
Yes.
The All-22 film?
Yeah.
And a lot of times people talk about the All-22. I'll watch, and sometimes I don't even know what I'm particularly looking for, but you'll see.
But if you go in with looking at one thing, you can follow it.
If you see greatness...
If he's open every play,
you see what happens, because he's so exceptional that it jumps off the page.
Yeah, there was a couple of plays where Jalen Hurts had to scramble out a little bit, and he found Devontae Smith. Is that because he's just breaking off his patterns and finding the open space? Is he too good for anybody to cover? I can't wait to I call it the pullback. I can't wait to be able to see the whole field when Devontae Smith was thrown to and see exactly what he was doing.
So I had one minor concern in what I just laid out, which was all positive. How many guys were on the defensive side of the ball? I mentioned one.
Under 25? Josh Sweat? And he's what? He's 24, 25?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
That's it.
They don't have a lot of youth on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah, but they have three first-round picks, baby!
Well, that is big.
If Jalen Hurts turns out to be a winner, you could potentially rebuild your defense at three levels in one draft.
Absolutely.
I am a little... the defensive line, they played... Josh Sweat was phenomenal.
He's awesome.
Your boy.
Very impressed.
I'll tell you what, he made a lot of tackles. I brought it up yesterday. On a third and goal, they threw an out to a running back, and Josh Sweat was in on the breakup or on the tackle, whatever it was. He ran down a running back at one point Sunday also. He was all over the place. Although they're older, that defensive line did play really well, and they can get better.
Yeah, but just for the purposes of looking towards the future, there's not a ton of young defensive pieces where you go, oh, that guy. Like, Josh Sweat's it to me.
Yeah, no, that's why Jalen Hurts succeeding this year is so mission critical.
Yeah.
Because I honestly would like them to invest on the offensive line with one of those first-round picks and invest two picks in the secondary. And,
let's get nuts and get a linebacker in here.
A playmaking linebacker?
Let's get silly and take a first-round linebacker.
Stop.
You can do that when you have three first-round picks, Bob.
What did I tell you, Jamie? Okay. The name that... I'm going to see if Jamie listened to me. The name I want you to know and focus on and everything.
The kid from Notre Dame?
Kyle Hamilton.
Yeah, Kyle Hamilton.
And then we have The Inn as a show.
Yeah.
On the first round pick, Kyle comes to town from Notre Dame. He is awesome. and you could maybe do it with the second or the third of your first round picks.
I would like that very much.
A safety that has breakneck speed, a ball hawk.
I love safety play.
So do I. But they always consider it unimportant.
Yeah, they do in today's NFL.
It's considered unimportant until you have a really good one, right?
Yeah.
No question. You're right. You know? I mean, it is.
Yeah.
If you find, but they don't invest in it.
No. I'd rather invest in a cornerback than a safety, in fairness, if we're talking first-round picks.
You get me a playmaking linebacker and a safety that really shows up.
See, I think that could take the middle of the defense could be transformed in one offseason. That just the heart of your defense could just be.
I know, but Jerry Robinson, the last linebacker they took in the first round?
I got you.
You know, they just don't value it like we want them to value it.
I tell you, Philadelphia will become obsessed with Kyle Hamilton come draft time. Just think about it. Come on, Kyle. Come home.
Three first-round picks would be nice.
Oh, that'd be so nice. Come on!
The John Kincade Show on 97.5, The Fanatic, Philadelphia.